Deputy Adams, please. Thank you.
Today, our people face the sixth austerity budget since the economic crisis began. In that time, €25 billion has been taken out of the economy in cuts and taxes. And today, you'll take out another €3.5 billion. And in all this time, Taoiseach, the digouts for the bankers and the bondholders has continued. €64 billion of the €67 billion you borrowed from the Troika has been given to the banks. There's been a bailout for bankers, but no digouts for ordinary citizens. But Taoiseach, you know yourself, the people who are paying for this, they include the elderly, the sick, the people who have lost their home health care, the people with disabilities, the unemployed, lone parents, and those who have been forced to emigrate. Taoiseach, you promised a democratic revolution, but what we've got is Fianna Fáil Mark II, Fianna Fáil Lite. You promised no more blank cheques for banks. You promised progress on legacy debt. You're making the wrong choices. You must know that in your heart. You must know, and certainly Labour should know, that you're making the wrong choices. And you're ignoring the social consequences of the actions that you're taking. Agus Mara Jarter and Sean O'Call, as come up bar na Brogy Mora, ca Goran Shea a cuss. So Taoiseach, how can the government stand over cuts in child benefits or introducing new property taxes while digging out the bankers? Was this budget equality proofed? And I asked you this question at the last budget, was it poverty proofed?
Thank you. Taoiseach.
Deputy Adams, everybody in here shares the view and the objective of restructuring and re-engineering the scale of bank debt that was inherited here following the incompetence of the previous administration. It's not as simple as just pressing a button and saying it's over. We have undertaken, both from the officials in the Department of Finance and at ministerial level, really direct discussions, both at a European Council level and at the ECB level. I've been through this before, and I have to tell you that a great deal of work has been done here. I don't want to see a situation where we have to pay out over €3 billion next March, as is the requirement following on the promissory notes introduced. You're aware of what government did this year in respect of the payment which was due in March of 2012. Now, I'm serious with you, Deputy Adams, that there is some very clear discussions have taken place and are taking place at ECB level with our officials and our minister. We've had support for a restructuring of that from many quarters, not just confined to Europe but beyond, and we are pursuing that. And as I said yesterday in answer to a question, patience is always an element of negotiations with Europe, and we've shown a degree of patience here now, and we'd like to move these discussions on. In regard to drafting the budget here, I listened to your own proposals from your party. We don't want to touch anything. You seem to have some mythical figure of being able to bring in taxes that will run the country and protect everybody's interests from an extraordinary small number of people whom you assume have extreme wealth. These figures just don't add up, Deputy. Now, everybody in this country knows that we face a very challenging time. Everybody knows that we face a very challenging time. You asked me, is this budget poverty-proofed? I was asked this question yesterday. Insofar as we can, those who are vulnerable, isolated, lonely, those who need attention, those who need care, we try to protect that as strongly and to the best extent that we can, Deputy Adams. There are always cases. That are exceptional and that always come to attention, whether it be persons in the cystic fibrosis unit in St. Vincent's or people who have a range of difficulties in any area around the country. And they empathise with understanding of how to deal with that. But this is a case of where government are required by the programme that we're in to meet the requirements of moving our country on, to restore our economic good health, to grow our economy, to continue to attract investment in here, and to make an improvement, continuously, on the the live register figures with particular reference to unemployment, which will be published at 11 o'clock, and they show an improvement. It's not by any means, Deputy Adams, as you well know, the harbinger of saying we're through all of this. There are challenges up ahead, but we are moving in the right direction.
Thank you.
And our people around the country say to me, you must keep at this because the problem will not go away unless you deal with it. And that's what both parties in government are setting out. It's, believe you me, it's not with any great pleasure or satisfaction that any minister has to stand up in these straitened economic circumstances and say we have to make hard decisions. But tough decisions must be made in the interests of all our people and our country, because our ambition is to retrieve our economic independence, to come out of this programme, to be able to see the Troika go home and fly on our own, where we continue to be competitive and attractive for investment and a location for jobs to be created.
Thank you.
That's our ambition, and today's budget, Deputy Adams, will build on that platform and move us further in that direction.
Deputy Adams.
Yeah, you see, the problem, Taoiseach, is that austerity is not working, except for the tiny minority who are benefiting from it. And you must be talking to different people from the people who are talking to me. Do you talk to carers? Do you talk to the children or the parents of children with disabilities? Do you talk to the people who are denied home health care? Do you talk to the people who are on the dole? Do you talk to people who invested in tax and who worked and paid their taxes throughout all of their years and now are in trepidation about what's coming down this afternoon? So, Taoiseach, it's a no-brainer. It was a choice between not giving money to big bankers or to the elites, or taking money and taxes from those who can best afford it, and taking money of those who can't afford it, then you have to take the money from those who can most afford it. Those who can't pay most should pay most. And it's a disgrace that Labour have tied themselves to something which would have James Connolly spinning in his grave. So.
Thank you. Please finish.
Even on the cost of taking another 3.5 billion out of the economy, would you not concede?
Thank you.
That austerity is not working. And secondly, would you not just say straight out, you did not equality-proof this budget? You can't say, insofar as we can, you either equality-proof it or you don't.
Thank you. Taoiseach.
Well, you see, Deputy Adams, you come in here every day and you make the same argument. Now, we've had a long tradition here in the country that on the run-in to budgets, that all parties are entitled to submit their claims for alternative budgets to the Department of Finance to be assessed independently and to be valued independently. And your party did not bother to do that, Deputy. So it ill behoves you.
All right, settle down, please.
It ill behoves you. It ill behoves you to come in here and castigate the Labour Party or anybody else. You can have your rows with Fianna Fáil if you wish. But the test was for you and your party, why did you not submit your alternative budgetary propositions to the Parliament and have them costed independently? And be clear on this, Deputy Adams. See all those... All those young people in the gallery. When they grow up, when they go through their schools, when they become adults in this country, we want to have a situation where our economic good health has been restored, where there's an engine to drive our economy efficiently and competently, but we'll never again have a situation where a government runs riot with the people's money, and that we restore that good health to our economy, where investment, attraction and jobs can actually result. That's what's important here, and we want to protect those frontline services and those people who are vulnerable in as fair a way as we can. And that's why, Deputy Adams, that's why, if you decide as an alternative to a property tax, for instance, you load on income taxes and tax on work, and that's not going to help the situation where you have to develop your economy. And the monies that will come in from that, in the vast majority of cases, will be retained by local authorities for services for local people, and that's what local people wish to see. Good, competent government delivering in their interests. So the next time, your proposals over to the Department of Finance. Have them costed, and then you'll see how daft they are.
Deputy Shane Ross.